Hey guys, welcome back to another great week of Speech and Language with Miss Juliet. Today, we are going to listen to the story The Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza. You might remember the week before last, we listened to the story The Little Red Hen, and she made a loaf of bread in that story. So this one is a little bit different. It's updated with a new recipe. Of course, we're going to listen to our story, but before we do that, we're going to learn the sign for pizza. Then we'll listen to our story. Then we'll review our story vocabulary, answer story questions. We'll compare and contrast the two stories, The Little Red Hen and The Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza. And then we'll finish with our song about pizza. All right, let's jump in and learn the sign for pizza. Pizza, 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 pizza. Okay, now we're gonna jump into our story. Let's take a listen.
Makes a Pizza, retold by Philemon Sturges and illustrated by Amy Walrod. The little red hen had eaten the last slice of her tasty loaf of bread. She'd sipped a cup of chickweed tea and taken her nap. Now she was hungry again, so she scratched through her cupboard and spied a can of tomato sauce. "Why don't I make a lovely little pizza?" she said to herself. She rummaged through her pan drawer. There were bread pans, cake pans, muffin pans, frying pans, all kinds of pans, but not one single pan was large and round and flat. "Cluck," she said, "I need a pizza pan." She stuck her head out of the window. "Good morning," she called. "Does anybody have a pizza pan?" "Not I. Quack, quack," said the duck. "Not I," ruff, ruff, said the dog. "Not I," meow, meow, said the cat. "Very well, then, I'll fetch one myself," said the little red hen. So she went to the hardware store. She bought a pizza pan, a large mixing bowl, and a pizza slicer, and some other stuff. When she got home, she opened the cupboard door. She saw beans and rice, sugar, spices, jars of jam, and jars of honey, and even pickled eggplant, but no flour. "Cluck, cluck," she said, "I need flour." She stuck her head out the window. "Hello," she said. "Who'll run to the store and get me some flour?" "Not I," said the duck. "Quack, quack." "Not I," said the cat. "Meow, meow." "Not I," said the dog. "Ruff, ruff, ruff." "Very well, then, I'll fetch some myself," said the little red hen. So she went to the supermarket. She bought some flour, some salt, some oil, and some other stuff. When she got home, she opened the fridge. "Cluck, cluck," she said. There's cream cheese, blue cheese, string cheese, and Swiss cheese, but no mozzarella. So she stuck her head out of the window. "Excuse me," she said. "Who will go to the store and buy me some mozzarella?" "Not I," said the duck. "Quack, quack." "Not I," said the dog. "Ruff, ruff." "Not I," said the cat. "Meow, meow." "Very well, then, I'll fetch some myself," and the little said the little red hen. So the little red hen went to the delicatessen. She bought some mozzarella, pepperoni, and olives, some mushrooms, onions, and garlic, a can of 8 small anchovies, and some other stuff, but no pickled eggplant, When she got home, the little red hen put on her apron and stuck her head out of the window. "Good afternoon," she said. "Who will help me make some pizza dough?"
"Not I," said the duck.
"Quack, quack."
"Not I," said the dog.
"Ruff, ruff."
"Not I," said the cat.
"Meow, meow."
"Very well, then, I'll make it myself," said the little red hen. So she put the flour and some other stuff in her mixing bowl and stirred and mixed and mixed and kneaded and pounded until she had a big ball of pizza dough. After the dough rose, the little red hen rolled it flat, folded it, and rolled it again and spun it around in her hand several times. When the dough was just right, she tossed it way up in the air one last time for good luck and put it in her pizza pan. Then she stuck her head out of the window.
"Excuse me," she said. "Who will help me make the topping?"
"Not I," said the duck.
"Quack, quack."
"Not I," said the dog.
"Woof, woof."
"Not I," said the cat.
"Meow, meow."
"Very well, then, I'll make it myself," said the little red hen. So she chopped and grated and sliced. Next, she opened her can of tomato sauce and spread it all over the pizza dough. On top of that, she put some grated mozzarella, some sliced pepperoni, some chopped olives, some mushrooms, some onions and garlic, 8 small anchovies, and some other stuff. But no pickled eggplant. The little red hen looked at her pizza. It looked just right. She put it in the oven and sat down to sip a cup of chickweed tea. Pretty soon, a delicious smell drifted from the oven. It filled the room and floated out the window. "My lovely little pizza must be ready," she thought. It was lovely, but it was not little. So she stuck her head out the window. "Good evening," she said. "Would anybody like some pizza?" Can you guess what the duck said?
Mm. "Quack, quack."
Can you guess what the dog said?
"Ruff, ruff."
Can you guess what the cat said?
"Meow, meow."
They all said, "Yes, of course." But the cat scraped most of the topping off of his share. When the pizza was all gone, the little red hen made herself another cup of chickweed tea. Then she asked, "Who will help me do the dishes?" "Now, can you guess what that duck, the dog, and the cat each said?" They each said, "I will,
meow.
I will,
quack, quack.
I will,
woof, woof."
And they did.
All right. Now that we listened to our story, we are going to review our vocabulary. The story we just listened to was, of course, The Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza. What were all of the things that she needed to make a pizza? Well, she needed a big pizza pan. When she was calling to her friends, she called out the window. She had to go to the store for the ingredients. And she served her pizza on some dishes. The ingredients for her pizza were flour, cheese. She needed an oven to bake the ingredients. And ultimately, she got her pizza. What did the little red hen cook? Did she cook pizza, corn, or a hamburger? Touch or say what you think the answer is. She cooked pizza. Yum. Why did she have to go to the hardware store? Because she needed to buy some nails, she needed to buy a pizza pan, or she needed to buy a pencil. She needed to buy a pizza pan. Where did the hen go to buy the flour? To the mall, to a restaurant, or to the grocery store? She went to the grocery store. What did she use to make the pizza crust? Did she make the pizza crust out of a tomato, sugar, or dough? Pizza dough. Mmm. Who ate the pizza? The duck, the cow, or the farmer? One of her friends was a duck, and he helped her eat the pizza. What did the animals do to help at the end of the story? Did they help do the dishes? Did they help buy a cookbook? Or did they help take a bath? They helped wash the dishes at the end. That's very nice of them, since she made that pizza all by herself. Okay, we are going to compare and contrast those two stories that we spoke about. The Little Red Hen, which we listened to the week before last, and the Little Red Hen makes a pizza. So let's think, where did each story happen? The Little Red Hen happened on a farm, and a Little Red Hen makes a pizza. She was in an apartment, and she had to find her ingredients at the store. Who was in the story? In both stories, it was the Little Red Hen. And how? How did she make both the bread and the pizza? She had to bake them in the oven. That was something similar between both stories. What ingredients were the same in both stories and different? Well, in Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza, she needed cheese. In Little Red Hen Makes some Bread, she did not need cheese. But for both the loaf of bread and the pizza, she needed some flour. Let's think, did her friends help her in the story, The Little Red Hen? No, they did not help her. They did not help her make the bread, and they did not help her eat it either. But in The Little Red Hen Makes a Pizza, the friends helped her eat the pizza, and they helped her wash the dishes after, which was very nice. Okay, we've made it to the end of our lesson. I hope you love this song as much as I do. Go ahead and get some wiggles out as we listen to this song about pizza.
Every single meal, then I got scurvy.
Sounds pretty real.
I used to eat those every single day. But then I had a pizza slice, and it blew me away. All I eat is pizza. It's pizza time. pizza. That's a na 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 na.
All right, you guys, I hope you had as much fun as I did with this lesson about pizza. See you guys next time.